Thanks so much for joining us here on the web. We begin with news of a suspected serial killer. A man known as Bob Evans is suspected of killing at least six people across the country, including several here in New Hampshire. Authorities say Evans died in prison back in 2010. At the time, he was serving a life sentence for the murder of Yusun Jun. She was found buried in the basement of the California home that she and Evans shared at the time. Authorities also believe that Evans is behind the disappearance of his girlfriend Denise Bowden of Manchester. She vanished back in 1981. Officials believe that she is dead, but so far her remains have not been found. Evans is also suspected of killing a woman and three young girls whose bodies were discovered in barrels in Allenstown. DNA testing shows that one of the young girls was Evans's daughter, and now authorities are concerned that her mother may be dead as well. They're now trying to identify all four victims. Evans used several aliases, and officials are not sure what his real name is. They say in the late 70s, he worked as a head electrician at the Wambach Mill. A man from Maine is accused of leaving a four-year-old in his pickup truck while he tried to race away from police in Milton. State police say it all started when 39-year-old Jeremy Hovey LeClaire allegedly tried to initiate a police chase in Dover last night by driving aggressively. A Summersworth officer spotted the truck and followed it onto Route 16. Police were eventually able to use a device to flatten one of the tires in Milton on his truck. They say that LeClaire kept driving until he hit a dead-end road and then took off on foot, running onto Milton Three Ponds while leaving that four-year-old in his truck. While two troopers and a canine were trying to arrest him, they all fell through the ice. Other officers helped to pull them out of the water. No one was seriously hurt. LeClaire is due in court today to face a number of charges, including two counts of endangering the welfare of a child. A local couple is speaking out after a terrifying ordeal. Police say they were victimized by a hostage scam called virtual abduction. The couple, who do not want to be identified, say that each got a phone call Wednesday saying that the other person was in a car crash and had been kidnapped. They were given specific orders about where to drive to and where to send money to in order to save each other's lives. They say that each time they sent money, they were ordered to send more while being warned not to call police or the other person would be killed. After several hours, police ultimately got involved and the victims each learned that the other was safe.
They knew it to a T, what buttons to push and what to say to you. And any of us in this room, if they tell you that they have your girlfriend, your friend, your neighbor, whomever, and that they're going to torture them and kill them, you're going to do whatever, whatever they say.
The couple lost about $4,000. Police say the money transfers and cell phones were traced to Puerto Rico. The FBI is now handling the case. A Raymond man is accused of selling drugs from the drive-through window at the Burger King in Epping. Police say 20-year-old Garrett Norris sold marijuana to customers who asked for him by the nickname Nasty Boy and then placed an order for extra crispy fries. Officers say the drugs were provided in coffee cups. Police caught him in the act over the weekend and also arrested an assistant shift manager, 19-year-old Megan Dearborn.
In order to keep the community safe, we have to stop the drug dealing, whether it's marijuana, heroin, or fentanyl. And we want people to know, we want this to send a message to drug dealers out there that if you're doing it, we're going to investigate you and we will arrest you.
Both Norris and Dearborn are free on bail this morning. A new report is revealing just how bad the drug crisis was in New Hampshire in 2016. The report was compiled by the New Hampshire Drug Monitoring Initiative. With 85 cases still pending, it found that overdose deaths in 2016 are projected to increase by 7%. Drug-related emergency room visits jumped by 28%, and the life-saving drug Narcan was administered nearly 2,800 times. That's up 4%. One positive statistic, the number of people seeking help for opioid addiction. It jumped by 28%. After a few well-deserved days off, the Patriots were back on the practice field in Foxborough yesterday. They have 2 weeks to prepare for their next game, Super Bowl 51 in Houston against the Atlanta Falcons.
I think right now you have the opportunity to be comfortable in your own settings of, you know, meeting space, film room, sleeping in your own bed. You can kind of get a jump on taking advantage of this time to watch tape, get prepared.
Patriots fans already have Super Bowl Sunday marked on their calendars, but you can head to Patriot Place this coming Monday to help send the team off. The rally starts at 9:30 a.m. outside the hall at Patriot Place. Coach Bill Belichick and team leaders are expected to speak. It will be very exciting. And that's it for your morning webcast. We'll have more news on the air today at noon.